between 8 p.m. till 12 p.m., 4 hours on the Bosphorus. This is the most important part of Istanbul. There's no any single beton building in Cappadocia because government doesn't let any big hotel. Pamukkale is this.
Okay.
We this. Call it White Travertines. This mountain, which is called Babadağ. You meet our staff first, and then they take you to the driver.
Okay.
This is our system here, and which is more comfortable and...
So many people, inshallah, will contact with you after this video. Assalamualaikum.
Alaikum salam.
Okay, it's Mr. Nabi. Okay, Mr. Nabi, tell us your good price for your tourist plan. Which kind of tourist plan you are giving?
Yeah, let me tell you about the tour details.
Okay.
Because all the tours are flexible. We do daily tours in every tourism destination in Turkey.
Mm-hmm.
So the dates are very flexible because from one day till 1 month, we can fill every day with the activities. Since we have guaranteed tours in every place of Turkey. Every day guaranteed departure. So about up to the time of the guests, we organize, like we fill the dates, you know. So let me start from Istanbul. In Istanbul, we have 3-4 main activities, starting with Bosphorus tour. Bosphorus we do in the daytime, nighttime, and sunset time. These are all different times in the day. And for example, in the daytime, we do 2 hours in the whole cruise. When the guests do Bosphorus cruise, they are able to see Europe and Asia at the same time. Because, as you know, this Bosphorus connects Europe and Asia by this three big bridges: Bosphorus, Fatih Sultan Mehmet, and Yavuz Sultan Selim. And in the evening time, we do Turkish night on the Bosphorus, which is the most popular activity in Istanbul. Because of pandemic, it's closed now, but normally we do between 8 p.m. till 12 p.m., 4 hours on the Bosphorus. This tour including pick-up and drop-off services from every hotel in Istanbul and open buffet dinner in the boat, soft drinks and Turkish entertainments. These entertainments are like dervish dance and Balkan area dancings and our all cultural dancings from every part of Turkey. And beside of this, we do old city tour. This is the most important part of Istanbul. This is the heart of Istanbul, old city, where the Hagia Sophia, Blue Mosque, Topkapi Palace, Basilica Cistern, Hippodrome. These are all on the same place. We do full day tour in that area with the guide by walking, and you are able to see all these places in one place. So this is another day. After the old city tour, we go to Grand Bazaar and Egyptian Bazaar. These two bazaars, the biggest bazaars in Istanbul. We visit the places for shopping and to buy traditional brands, not international. All the stuff is Turkish. And another activity is Princess Islands. We have 4 islands in Istanbul: Büyükada, Heybeliada, and Turkish names. There are 4 in total, and they're all in the same place. We do 2 hours boat trip from Istanbul to that places. And we visit all of them, but we stop in the biggest one, which is called Büyükada. This is very big island. It's like a town which has hotels, restaurants, and residence houses. We do a day tour in that place with horse ridings, bicycle ridings, and electricity car. We go around the islands. By walking is not possible to see all islands. That's why we use electricity cars to see all places. So after the day, we come back to Istanbul, 2 hours trip again by boat. This is another full day tour. And another activities, we do some tours near Istanbul, like Bursa, Sapanca, Şile. These are all 2 hours distance from Istanbul, and we are able to do in the same day, like going in the morning and coming back at night. So among of them is The most popular one is Bursa. We have Uludağ Mountain there. In winter time, we have option for skiing. It is the biggest skiing resort in Turkey. So in winter time, we have that option in that mountain. After the mountain, we come back to city. Bursa is very old city, which also has Osman Gazi, Mosque and Osman Gazi Tomb also. Mm-hmm. And we visit that places first, and then Silk Bazaar. Silk is very popular, not as much as quality like Pakistan, but it's very good there. And also we dessert dessert factory. The best dessert in Turkey we have in Bursa. So okay. We visit that factory so guests can make shopping there. Well, and after dessert factory, we go to Green Mosque. This is the biggest mosque in Bursa. We visit that place. After that, we come back to Istanbul. This is like full day plan. And another one that I told is Sapanca. It's the name of the lake. There's a big lake which is called Sapanca. And near the lake, we also have a waterfall area. So what we do, we visit this waterfall area, which has some activities there, like zip line. So for the families who have kids, it's very good place because it has activities like zip line or ATV motorcycle tour around the waterfalls. After that place, we go to the lake. On the lake, we give free time to the passengers to walk around on the beach. And there's a sea bicycle. We do that activity there. So this is another full day. We come back to Istanbul in the evening, like full day. And then another one that I told is Şile Ava. This is also 2 hours from Istanbul. And Şile Ava is more about swimming. The guests who prefer to swim, that's only the place in Istanbul to visit, because inside of Istanbul, we don't have that option in Marmara Sea. That's why we prefer this place to go to swim. So we go to this place, Şile, and we give free time on the beach for swimming. And then we have an activity. There's a river in Şile. This river and sea meets in one point. So at that point, we do canoe. We do tours with canoe on the river. We do that activity and swimming activity in Şile Ava. So around the Istanbul, these are the places that I can tell. And so Turkey, you know, we have some other touristic destinations like Cappadocia, Pamukkale, Antalya, Bodrum. These are all different type of tourism. Like Cappadocia is all about the cultural tourism and history. It has a huge history and very unique place. Like I can show you like this Cappadocia. Mm-hmm. It's all the hotels in Cappadocia are from stone and caves. There's no any single beton building in Cappadocia because government doesn't let any big hotel to build there. You know, all the hotels are boutique size, but original cave and stones. So the main activities we do there, let me tell you how to go first. Like we have driving option, also plane option. We usually prefer plane with the small amount of guests, like private families, like 5-6 person. We prefer flight. It's 1 hour 20 minutes flight. But for the big amount of groups, we prefer to go by bus. As we can also visit some other points on the way to Cappadocia. So by driving is about 10 hours, but the way is never boring because there are like lakes and forests to visit on the way. So let me tell you about the main activities, what we do in Cappadocia. First, the main activity is hot air balloon. This is the main activity. It is the symbol of Cappadocia. There is only sunrise time in Cappadocia. This balloon time, we pick our guests from the hotel before sunrise. For now, let's say 5 a.m. in the morning, we take them to the balloon area and they watch the preparation of the balloons. It takes like an hour. And then the balloon takes off before the sunrise. When you're in the sky, you see the sunrise when you're in the balloon. That's the point. And it is standard 1 hour flight. After 1 hour, they land, and at the landing place, all the balloon equipment is there. The team is there, and they help you to leave the basket. And then there's a celebration at that landing place, and they give you flight certificates that you did this balloon. It's like a symbol.
Okay.
So after that, we take you back to your hotel to do your breakfast and stuff. So still you have full day because you finish very early with the balloon. You still have full day. In this full day, we have 2 full day tours in Cappadocia. First, North Cappadocia, second, South Cappadocia. In North Cappadocia, what we do, we go to Open Air Museum, where has the Pharaoh chimneys, that place, the Pharaoh chimneys.
Okay.
We visit that place, and then we go to Uçhisar Castle. This is the highest castle in Cappadocia, and we go to the top, and you can see all cave land of Cappadocia. After that, we go to a valley, which is called Pigeons. There are many pigeons there, and we see from the top first, and then we enter the valley for walking. And the day is like full day like this, and then second day we do South Cappadocia, covers Ihlara Valley, which is called also Green Valley. The valley is totally green, and we walk this valley like 5 kilometers. It's a bit walking tour.
Okay.
And there is a river inside the valley. We have restaurants located on the water, and we do the lunch there. And after this, we go to underground city, which is another popular destination in Cappadocia. There are 5 underground cities in Cappadocia. We go to the biggest one. This is like 7 floors down. This has a huge history. Mainly, I can say, like, people lived there million years ago to protect themselves from the war for on the earth. So they lived there like with animals, you know, they okay. even made agriculture and everything. Mm-hmm. So they made a life underground. So you see the proofs from history there. And so these 2 places in South Cappadocia tour, the Green Valley and the underground city, and we finish the day. Another activity is ATV motorcycle safari tour. We call it safari tour. This is in the sunset time. 2 hours we do in the sunset. And that's all activities for Cappadocia. And then we go to Pamukkale. This is 1 day. Pamukkale, we have, let me show you. Pamukkale is this.
Okay.
We call it white travertines.
This is Pamukkale.
This is Ephesus, actually. This is Pamukkale.
Okay, this is Pamukkale.
Yes,
this
exactly.
Is,
this is Ephesus.
Ephesus.
Ephesus, which okay. is close to Pamukkale, actually. They're
okay.
just 2 hours distance from each other.
Okay, okay.
So, 1 day this and 1 day this.
Fine.
Yeah. So, in Pamukkale, what we do, first, the main place, of course, we visit travertines. We call it Cotton Castle also. It looks white, and, you know. Mm-hmm. And we walk on this water. On this water is not deep. We can walk on
okay.
it.
Okay.
Yeah.
This water.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
So after this place, we go to Masterpiece Theater. It's very big theater, the historical one, Masterpiece Theater. And we go to Cleopatra Antique Pool. This pool, we people believe that whoever swims there makes her beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
This is the history of Cleopatra, queen. And we visit that pool, and then Masterpiece Theater, and Hierapolis Antique Museum. Mainly these 4 places in Pamukkale, and we finish the day. This is like full day tour. If we continue to Ephesus, it is 2 hours driving, but need to sleep overnight in Pamukkale, because Ephesus is another day. And we go to Ephesus. Ephesus is an antique city. This castles there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is also another day tour. This is totally a small antique city. We visit okay. this antique city, and the whole day we visit this castles and, you know, the, I don't know, this called Stun, this we call this name, I don't remember how it's called in English.
Okay,
actually,
that's fine,
this
no problem.
Is, yeah, visit these places. So after that, we come back to Istanbul by flight, or if we go by driving, and driving again back to Istanbul. So usually in the Turkey packages, we cover Istanbul, Cappadocia, Pamukkale, and Ephesus. This already takes 7 nights, 8 days. If passengers want to spend more time, we also have coastal option. Okay. Antalya, Bodrum, and Fethiye, these places. Some guests can prefer coastal area instead of Cappadocia or Pamukkale. Mm-hmm. This, as I said, it is very flexible. We can do every day different. And it is not important amount of the guests. It can be 1 person or 50 person. We can still organize, because as I say, we have guarantee tour in every destination every day. So for Antalya is all about big resorts, you know, like all inclusive resorts. People usually stay in that resort, spend all the time there, because it has private beach and, you know, all the meals in the hotel. Fethiye area, there are boutique hotels there. It's not like resorts, but there are activities like boat tour, which is like full day, and visit 12 islands and some coves in Ölüdeniz. So, and then paragliding, there is boat tour, which is very popular, and paragliding. Paragliding, it is the most popular paragliding place in Turkey. And the starts from, let me show you the point, like this. This mountain, which is called Babada, and the paragliding starts from there, like this, and land on the beach, Ölüdeniz beach.
Okay, that's
yeah. It is the view from the mountain is amazing. You see all beach of Ölüdeniz, and. Okay. So these are the main activities in Ölüdeniz, but in these coastal places, we recommend more days, because you need to spend time on the beach, you need time for these activities. So if you choose coastal places, you need minimum 4 days, only for coastal area. So these are the main places that I can tell about Turkey. Of course, we have some other places like Black Sea or East Turkey. These are some other touristic destinations.
Trabzon.
Trabzon is all about green. It's on the Black Sea. This also needs 3 days minimum, because of also the distance. It is a bit far from Istanbul. Like by driving is 12 hours, and by flight 1.5 hours. So this is also an option. In Trabzon, we have a big lake, but the main thing in Trabzon is all about nature. It's all about green, sea and nature in the same place.
Paradise.
It's a paradise. Well, about Turkey, our popular destinations, that all I can say. And also I want to say about the transportation services. We are also a transportation company. Providing transportation services all over Turkey, and with various types of options, like private, shuttle, or big amount of group transfers, and also VIP class, chauffeur service. So for every budget, we have services. That's what I mean. So yeah, and we are a member of Turkish Tourism Ministry, and all our vehicles belong to our own company, and our own drivers. And we believe that transportation is the main thing of the packages and all tours and everything, because in every activity, as you need the transportation, this is the first impression of the services. So right after you arrive in the airport, first you face our drivers and meet and greet stuff. So this is your first experience in your arrival. So we do it as much as good to give you, to make you feel relaxed and safe and enjoy your, start your all the package with the good experiences.
So yes, tell me in the last, how much the charge of all the tour, if you give us a good price and with a good discount, so which price is good for us?
Well, the prices are very changeable.
Okay.
Because the reason is, every time we give the price, the amount of the guests, you know, because group prices,
yes,
or even like one person or two person is the is different price, because you know you share the transfer, you share the hotel, you share the tour, you know. This these are all factors affect the prices.
Okay, that's
so fine. Let me tell you, like basically popular prices like private transfer, for example, in Istanbul, we do 25 euro. We believe that we have the best price in the market, and because we give really quality cars and vehicles, we only use Mercedes brand. We don't have any other brand.
Okay.
All our cars are Mercedes. When we know how many days you have in Turkey,
yes,
and the amount of the guests, and then it is very easy for us to give you the price and to do our best on the rates.
Yeah, okay,
you know?
That's fine. Thank you so much, Mr. Nabi. You give us a very precious.
My pleasure.
We have meet and greet on airports, you know. We have
24 hours.
24 hours, we have greeters there. Meet you there and they take you
to
the car.
Yeah, yeah. In every airport of Turkey, we have meet and greet stuff 24 hours. Usually in the world, drivers meet the passengers in the airport. But here our system is different. We put stable staff 24 hours in the airport only for meet and greet. So when you arrive to the gate, you meet our staff first and then they take you to the driver.
Okay.
This is our system here, and which is more comfortable and, you know,
that's
make
fun.
You feel relaxed. You don't need to wait at the arrival. You don't need to look for your driver. You don't need to find the car. You know, this meet and greet stuff help you for everything.
And then drivers have to park somewhere in the parking. This way you don't have to park. They are waiting in the curb area.
Definitely.
As soon as the greeter call them, they bring the car right in front.
Okay.
So you don't have to even walk 2 feet right there.
Okay, that's fine.
Exactly.
That's the best service. Medium
best service.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Nabi, thank you so much for your precious time.
You're welcome.
Inshallah,
my pleasure.
So many people, inshallah, will contact with you after this video. So
Sure.
Let me add one thing. Sorry to interrupt. Our cars are VIP Plus are custom made. He is very particular, very keen on that. He put a lot of money in that. Sometimes double the car cost, he put that much money in that. Inside is such a beautiful one, just like VVIP cars.
Good. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much for your time, for your all the your tourist plan. So,
you're most welcome.
Inshallah, we'll be discussed further for more detail. If we'll contact, everyone need a good services. That's
exactly.
Why.
And
exactly.
We are the best. Don't compromise.
And trusted services, of course.
Inshallah, inshallah. Okay, thank you so much. अच्छा ये थे मिस्टर नबी और इन्होंने सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन दी है और मुनीर भाई ये जितनी इन्फॉर्मेशन दी है ये आई थिंक बहुत अच्छी है और ये आप याद रखें कोई भी किसी किस्म का इसमें होटल में या टूरिस्ट में कोई किसी किस्म की हेल्प चाहिए हो किसी ने जाना हो और किसी ने यहाँ स्टे करना हो और अच्छे तरीके से आपको हर चीज़ गाइड की गई है तो आप यहाँ पर आके मैं इनका नंबर जो भी है सारा हर चीज़ मेंशन कर दूंगा तो इंशाल्लाह आपको डिस्काउंट भी मिलेगा और आपको अच्छी सर्विस मिलेगी तो ये थी आज की वीडियो इंशाल्लाह नेक्स्ट वीडियो में मिलेंगे नए टॉपिक के साथ सी यू गुड बाय अल्लाह हाफिज़